I want to just thank you for joining us for a few moments where we're going to give you the announcements, the things that are happening, a little bit of a report on youth camp this week. Yep. So, Rel, why don't you start by just telling us about Breaking the Ice Winter Camp for our students, our junior high, high school, and then a lot of the college age were mentors and, mm-hmm. and counselors. Go ahead.
Yeah, it was such a great weekend, a little exhausting, but it was really cool and really good. A lot of the teens came in, and at first I was like, oh man, these teens are a little timid. But towards the end of the weekend, they were jumping up and down, worshiping, and teens were giving testimony of how they gave their lives to the Lord for the first time and how they were able to worship and lift their hands and mm-hmm. didn't feel judged or didn't care who was watching them because they were just wanted to express how much they loved God. And our speaker, Pastor Chris, spoke on honesty and an honest connection and honest reality. And the teens were like, this is it's a really big deal to be honest with yourself and to have an honest connection with God. And so they really had a great time. They were just kept sharing testimonies about how their life was changed this weekend. So it was a good one. So.
You know, what was awesome was having Chris share, who mm-hmm. was a pastor here for years. He's now in Southern California, but mm-hmm. Having Chris share because he was saved in at camp.
Yeah.
And one of the things I didn't get to do Sunday morning here mm-hmm. is a girl that now lives in Salem and her boyfriend, which is now, this has been years and years and years and years mm-hmm. ago. They didn't realize until later that they were both at our first BTI. She knew it, he knew it, and next thing you know, they realized that the connection with Crossfire. Anyway, Sunday morning, they called me and said, do you mind if we come down? We just want to be in the Sunday morning service. And they came down. We went and ate with Pastor Chris and Corey afterwards, mm-hmm. and it was a cool thing because,
awesome.
Somebody that was saved in the very first BTI
cool.
winter camp, and that's been 20, yeah. I'm old, six, five, something.
A few.
It's been a while. So it was really an awesome, awesome time.
Yeah.
And I wish I could have brought them up, but we had someone's purse sold. Yes, and I'm going to bring that up because I think it's important. You know, this is not just the nice, easygoing church. And for you that are watching, some of you will have never been here, maybe because you're not able to go to church. Maybe you live out of the area. Mm-hmm. And this announcement time during our live show, or some people tune into it. But for you that are here, let me just say that in a hospital, you wash your hands a lot because you might catch something. In church, it shouldn't be. We may act like it, but in any church, sick people are there. Yeah. And in fact, mm-hmm. if there isn't, you're not really being the church.
Yeah.
So, you know, we bring people in. Well, we had someone steal a purse. Is it the first time? No.
Will it be the
We've
last?
Had bags, backpacks, computers, a lot of those things. Now we have security. We have ushering on top of that. We try to watch out for it. We got cameras. All I'm going to tell you is you got to do your part too and be very careful because when you invite everyone, everyone comes. When you love and show love for everyone, whether you agree with them or not, guess what? People like to be loved.
Yeah.
And so this church is that way and you get all kinds. And mm-hmm. some, you know, figure they got to benefit from church.
Right.
It just happened to be somebody's wallet and purse. So sad to say, but true.
Right.
So off that subject now, Pastor John, tell us about youth camp, and then we got to get into some other stuff. How was all your right. take on the weekend?
Oh, I loved it. I got an opportunity to be a part of the worship team. Physically tiring, but spiritually I was very, very...
Voice sounds a little weak.
That's all right. So I got a chance to be a part of that worship team, and then being kind of physically tired, but spiritually I feel really refreshed. Mm-hmm. And honestly got a chance to connect with the teens in a different way than I have, you know, I've been a part of our youth ministry for 16 years and seeing different ones come and go. And probably the funniest moment and sad moment at the same time, I was praying for a young guy on Sunday afternoon after church, prayed with him because his mom is dealing with some illnesses. And they're saying she doesn't have long to live, and he's just broken up about it. And so, you know, we're holding him, we're hugging him, praying for him. and he was feeling loved, and he, you know, even though it's a difficult time, he was just, the family and the love around him was just giving him strength, and you could see that. 30 seconds later, you know, we're in the cafe, and we're screaming happy birthday and singing happy birthday for another person that's in our, you know, that's on our leadership team for the youth. And so it's interesting. You learn to mourn with those who mourn and rejoice for those who rejoice. It's kind of all right there, you know, in a 30-second to a minute span. But, you know, connecting with the teens and being a part of something where God is moving in the young people's lives is just incredible. And I'm humbled by it. So.
You know, it's weird because you just kind of jump from one thing to the other here. You kind of do that, sounds like, in the ministry. That being said, your beard is growing in better than I've ever seen it.
I'm working on it.
I'm just saying. I don't know about you out there, but I think his beard's looking better all the time. So it's getting full.
My wife's hoping for it to end at some point.
Squirrel. Oh, wait, it's on your
all
face.
Right. Anyways.
Oh, mine too.
So. Sorry.
Anyway, so tell us a little bit about Man Camp.
Okay.
And I got to say, I'm pretty excited about right now. I'm lining up some different speakers. Mm-hmm. I just interviewed a man who has an incredible testimony about forgiveness, and I'm hoping he can come and share that at the Man Camp and just how to deal with forgiving a pretty tragic situation. So I'm just excited about the thing, the speakers, the lineup. So I want to encourage people to save that date. Tell us about, you know, just how you have experienced Man Camp and why guys should come.
You know, I love Man Camp. There's too many Lone Rangers out there. So many guys kind of just putting their head down, putting their hand to the plow, doing their own thing. They get isolated easily, stuck in a rut or stuck in a corner by themselves. And it's hard for men to sometimes break down and reach out to other men. And one of the things I love about our Man Camp every year is that guys get to break some of those barriers down. They get to be open and honest with themselves, open and honest with each other. And you see a real kind of healing take place for a lot of men, if not all the men that come, but then also this strength that they come away with, where they feel like, man, I'm not alone in this. There's other men right next to me going through what I'm going through. And that's really what the body's about. And that's what Man Camp does. There's tons of other things that Man Camp does and offers. It's an incredible experience the whole time. But that's one of the things, is it strengthens men to help strengthen other men. It's just awesome.
April 15th through the 17th, save the date. And tell us a little bit about what's coming up on Easter Sunday.
Easter Sunday, we are going to be having our Easter egg hunt, our annual Easter egg hunt with lots and lots of eggs. But it's just a free community event where you guys can come on out and invite your friends and your family to just join in and have a little fun with us. And we'll
pack the house is what we're going to do.
We want more than before last year.
It was, well, last year, I don't know if we can fit any more in than last year.
Yeah. I think a little bit, maybe.
We're giving a big bear away this year, too.
Yeah, we're giving away a big 8-foot bear and
two
for each campus. And so, got to find the golden eight, and you get to take that big thing home with you.
All right. Lucky you.
Yep. Lucky you.
But they have an alternative.
There is an alternative. You can get a gift card to Toys R Us and a smaller bear if that's what you'd prefer, but whatever you would like.
All right. We also have a Sunday morning early service.
Yes.
Now, we do that at 8:30, and we do it. Anyone is welcome. We would like everyone to be able to come early. It is an hour and 15 minutes max.
Yeah.
I mean, it can't go over that because then I miss preaching at the other campus. So hour and 15 minutes maximum, sometimes an hour. Now, I don't want that to be your encouraging reason to come, but we do have a time of worship. Yeah. We do have some basic announcements. We miss that fellowship time. But one of the reasons for that service, that time at 8:30, is it allows all the staff to come and be involved. Tell us about that.
It's really awesome because those who would like to serve in Kids Town or the nursery toddlers or any other ministry here at Crossfire, they're able to sit in a service, sit in one and serve in another. And so it's exciting because I don't miss out on fellowship time when hearing the word and getting into the vision with Crossfire, and I still get to serve in the other service. So that's what we encourage you guys to do. Help out a little bit and still enjoy the message.
Yeah.
So many other things. We got all kinds of stuff in March. Check the calendar. Mm-hmm. Here it is right here.
Boom.
Zoom in.
Boom. check that. You can go online and check it. A lot of great things happening here at Crossfire. Want you to stay in touch with all the different ministries. outreaches, the feeding programs.
Yeah.
We have the things that happen every week. We have the stuff that happens periodically. Yeah. A lot of outreaches. Thanks for being a part. I'm going to be in Tennessee all week, but I'm going to come back ready to continue my series that I know you will enjoy on the Book of Acts.